So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. I am Manish Mishra and in this session I will bring to you 5 important questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B exam. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon for the regular notification about the videos, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information. So let's begin with the session guys with the question number 1. So India Australia Circular Economy Hackathon, which in short is named as IACE, okay? India Australia Circular Economy Hackathon IACE will be organized by Atal Innovation Mission. So there is one more news added to the Atal Innovation Mission in association to explore innovative ways to boost circular economy in India and Australia. So the question is, with which organization AIM will organize this hackathon? Kaun si organization ke saath Atal Innovation Mission will organize this hackathon? Okay, so let us discuss the news first. So guys, Atal Innovation Mission will organize this hackathon, which is named as India Australia Circular Economy Hackathon, in association with Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization. So remember the name, Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization, and along with this organization, Atal Innovation Mission will organize this hackathon. Now, what is this circular economy? So, circular economy ka matlab kya hota hai? So, in the circular economy, it is that economic system that is aimed at eliminating the waste. Jahan pe wastage kam se kam ho, eliminating waste and eliminating the continuous use of resources. Jahan pe jo usage of resources hai, wo continuous na ho, continuous usage of resources. So circular economy guys is that economy which is focused on the eliminating waste and continuous usage of resources, where the justiciable usage of resources is there. And this type of economy guys is basically focused on reuse, recycle. I hope you have heard of these 5 R's: reuse, recycle, refurbish, remanufacturing, etc. Okay, so I hope the meaning of circular economy is clear. And the objective guys of this hackathon is to explore innovative ways to develop a circular economy in both the countries, India and Australia. Circular economy kaise banai jaye, uske liye innovative ideas invite karne ke liye this hackathon will be organized. And these are the 4 themes of this hackathon: innovation in packing, reducing packing waste; innovation in food supply chains, again avoiding waste; creating opportunities for plastic waste reduction; and recycling critical energy metals and e-waste. And by the way, India is ranked number 3 in the production of e-waste. E-waste ke production mein India is ranked number 3. Number 1 pe is China, number 2 pe USA. And who can participate in this hackathon? So both students and the startups or MSME can participate. Students bhi participate kar sakte hain, startups or MSME bhi kar sakte hain. Okay. And if an Indian student won, agar koi Indian student jeetega, so he will get prize of rupees 2 lakh. While if a startup or an MSME will win, it will get rupees 5 lakh. ठीक है, लेकिन अगर Australian student होगा तो he or she will get 3500 Australian dollars. While if the winner is Australian startup or MSME, then it will get 9500 Australian dollar. Okay. So these are some basic facts about this hackathon. And now let's come back to the question. So the question was, with which organization AIM will organize this hackathon? This question guys can be asked in the word marker in your ESI section. So this organization is Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization. Commonwealth is also a group of nations. I hope you all must know Commonwealth group of nations, of which 54th members were recently added, which is Maldives. Okay, Maldives has become the 54th member of Commonwealth group of nations. Okay. And now let's talk about this question number 2, which is about this report, which is titled as World's Women Trends and Statistics 2020. Okay, World's Women Trends and Statistics 2020. So let's discuss this report. And the very important thing is that this report guys has been released by, United Nations. United Nations ne isko release kiya hai, to isliye report kafi important ho jati hai. And this report, the facts given in this report are based on the 6 parameters. 6 parameters ke upar based hai ye, aur wo kaun se hai? Population and families, health, education, economic empowerment and asset ownership, power and decision making of women and violence against women. So these are the six parameters based on which this report has been released by the United Nations. United Nations chief is Antonio Guterres. It is headquartered in New York. And let's talk about some parameters, jo important parameters hain aur jinse related kuch important data hai that we will discuss. So in the power and decision making area, women had only 28% managerial position in the year 2019, while only 18% of the enterprises are there which had women CEOs. theek hai, keval 18% enterprises aise thi jinki CEO mahilaen thi और केवल 28% मैनेजरियल पोजीशन महिलाओं द्वारा अक्वायर की गई थी इन द ईयर 2019. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन एंड गर्ल्स, सो आप सबने सुना होगा दैट ड्यूरिंग द ग्लोबल लॉकडाउन, ड्यूरिंग द कोरोना वायरस पैंडेमिक, अ लॉट ऑफ वुमेन फेस्ड सेक्सुअल एंड डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस. ओके, एंड दिस द सेम थिंग हैज बीन सेड बाय दिस रिपोर्ट. ओके, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द सिचुएशन ऑफ लेबर मार्केट, सो गाइस देयर इज अ ह्यूज गैप बिटवीन मेन एंड वुमेन इन द लेबर मार्केट. लेबर मार्केट में बहुत बड़ा गैप है बिटवीन मेन एंड वुमेन एज सेड बाय दिस डेटा. सो 47% वुमेन एंड 74% मेन आर इन द लेबर मार्केट, सो इट इज अ गैप ऑफ 27% का गैप इज देयर बिटवीन मेन एंड वुमेन लेबर फोर्स इन द मार्केट. हाईएस्ट जेंडर गैप इज इन साउथ एशिया फॉलोड बाय नॉर्दर्न अफ्रीका एंड वेस्टर्न एशिया. And if we talk about India, so in India the ratio of female to male labor force participation rate was just 29.80% in the year 2019, while it should be 50%. Okay, according to the norms, according to the definitions, this ratio should be 50%, but it was only 29.80% in the year 2019. So there is a huge gender gap in the labor market. And if we talk about the condition of unpaid work, so कितने ऐसे महिलाएं हैं, कितने ऐसे men हैं जो कि unpaid work करते हैं. So the time on unpaid domestic work, women spend 4.2 hours while men spend 1.7 hours. 1.7 hours men spend karte hain on the domestic work while women spend 4.2 hours. Inequality is lower in developed countries. Women 4 hours. Women spend twice the time on unpaid domestic work as compared to the men. And if you talk about inequality, so it is highest in Northern Africa and Western Asia, with women spending at least 7 times the time spent by men on the domestic work. Men agar 54 minutes kaam karte hain, 54 minutes kaam karte hain, then women work for 4 hours on the domestic work. So the inequality is very high in the Northern Africa and Western Asia region. All right. And if you talk about the country wise, so the inequality is highest in our neighboring country, Pakistan. All right. So this was about this report, guys. I hope the report is clear. And now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify the correct statement regarding this report. So the report has been released by Women for Women International. No, it has been released by United Nations. So this statement is incorrect. And next we have gender equality has been examined based on 6 parameters. So yes, there were 6 parameters in this report. Statement 2 is absolutely correct. And inequality in unpaid work is highest in Bangladesh. No guys, it is not Bangladesh, it is Pakistan. So Pakistan is the country where the inequality in unpaid work is the highest. So this statement is also incorrect, which means we have only one statement that is correct, option number C. Only 2 will be the correct answer here. And now let's come to the question number 3, which is about another report that has also been launched by a very important organization, United Nations Development Program. So Human Mobility Shared Opportunities, the name of this report, and the question itself is asking about the organization. Which organization has released this report? So as I told you, the organization is United Nations Development Program. Alright. So let's discuss about this, and let me tell you first that there are not so much fact in this report. Aapko sirf do cheeze yaad rakhni hai. You just have to remember 2 things from this report. Number 1 is the organization which has released this report, and number 2 is this fact which I am telling you. So UNDP has released this report, which is titled as Human Mobility Shared Opportunities. That is a review of the 2009 Human Development Report and the way ahead. And according to this report, the forced migration has doubled in the last 10 years to 79 million people. पिछले 10 सालों में जो migration है वो double हो गया है. कितना हो गया है? 79 million लोगों ने migrate किया है from one place to other. This fact is very important and this can be asked in your exam, guys. So remember this fact. And in 2015, migrants generated 9% of the global GDP. And also, this report says that migrants' rights are only protected on paper, बट ऑन द ग्राउंड द रियलिटी इज डिफरेंट. माइग्रेंट्स के जो राइट्स है वो केवल पेपर पे है, कागजों में है, बट अकॉर्डिंग टू द यू नो ग्राउंड रियलिटी इट इज क्वाइट डिफरेंट. बट देयर एक्सेस टू सोशल प्रोटेक्शन एंड सर्विस इज स्टिल लिमिटेड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रीज एज वी सी इन एग्जाम इन इंडिया ड्यूरिंग द कोरोना वायरस लॉकडाउन. माइग्रेंट्स की कितनी बुरी हालत हुई थी हम सब ने देखा है गाइस. So in this report, you have to remember the name of the organization and you have to remember this fact which says that the forced migration has doubled in the last 10 years to 79 million people, right? So the correct answer here is guys what? Option B, UNDP, United Nations Development Program, which was founded in the year 1965. It is headquartered in New York. Its parent organization is UN ECOSOC, United Nations Economic and Social Council. And Asian Steiner is the current administrator of UNDP. Alright, Asian Steiner. And now let's come to the question number 4. So guys, because of lack of news, I am bringing two questions from the static part. Okay, and these questions are also very good, very important questions. These can be asked in your exam. So let's discuss this question number 4. The committee to review the governance of boards of banks in India was formed in the year 2014. That's very important report because after on the recommendation of this report, a very important organization came up which suggested the formation of Bank Boards Bureau. So this was the organization which I was talking about. So the question is, who was the chairperson of this committee which had recommended the formation of Bank Boards Bureau? And the name of the committee is to review the governance of the boards of bank. This report, this committee was formed. So guys, this committee was formed in the year 2014 and it recommended the formation of Bank Boards Bureau. And this Bank Boards Bureau was established in the year 2016. And its one of the functions includes the recommendation on the appointment of heads of the public sector banks. Jo public sector banks hote hain, unke heads ki appointment ke recommendation is given by Bank Boards Bureau. And also for the consolidation of PSB, they also provide recommendation to the central government and to the RBI. Consolidation of public sector banks. So these are some functions of Bank Boards Bureau. It was established in 2016 on the recommendation of this committee, which is headed by Mr. P.J. Nayak. Alright, the committee's chairperson was Mr. P.J. Nayak. This Bank Boards Bureau is headquartered in Mumbai. It is headquartered in Mumbai and Bhanu Pratap is the current chairperson of Bank Boards Bureau. Alright. So therefore, guys, the correct answer is what? Option A, P.J. Nayak. So aapko isme committee ka chairperson yaad rakhna hai. You have to remember the chairperson of Bank Boards Bureau also. You have to remember the headquarters of Bank Boards Bureau also. Some functions and the launcher. Okay, so any of the question can be asked in an exam about the Bank Boards Bureau. And now again a very important question. Match the following committees with their correct chairperson. So some of the committees guys are very recent while some are quite old. So let's discuss ki kaun si committees hai unke kaun se chairpersons honge. So number one is resolution framework on COVID-19 related stress. So this was recently formed by RBI and the chairperson of this committee was Mr. K.V. Kamath. K.V. Kamath, so first is matching with S. Okay, and K.V. Kamath was the ex-chief of NDB. NDB ke wo ex-chief the. Now, can you tell me the current president of National New Development Bank, which is also known as the BRICS Bank? It is headquartered in Shanghai. It is headquartered in Shanghai. Can you tell me the new president of New Development Bank? Write down in the comments. Domestic Systematically Important Insurance. Like we have DSIBs, Domestic Systematically Important Banks. Similarly, Domestic Systematically Important Insurance ke liye bhi a committee banayi gayi thi, which was headed by Praveen Kutumbe. And can you tell me the name of three insurance companies which has been identified as the DSIIs? Write down in the comments. Digital Payments Committee, it was headed by Nandan Nilekani. And formation of NABARD was on the recommendation of B. Sivaraman Committee. Okay. So first is matching with S in option D also. Second is matching with Domestic System Praveen Kutumbe. Second is matching with P. So second is matching with P in option A only, which means option A will be the correct answer here. 1S, 2P, 3R and 4Q. Okay. So I hope guys all the committees are clear and write down in comments about the chairperson of NDB and the three DSII which have been recently recommended by the government. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope aapko ye session clear hai. But guys, before ending the session, Let me tell you one thing that in the yesterday session we were discussing about the Uttar Pradesh, and while discussing I told you about a portal YouSure. But guys, the correct name is not YouSure, the correct name is YouRise. Okay, the correct name of the portal is YouRise portal that was launched by students. So please make correction in this. The name of the portal is YouRise, not YouSure. Okay, and that's it for the session. I hope aapko session acha laga. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.